Mary O'Sullivan.
Mary O'Sullivan, yes.
Just going.
I had a double name. I was Mary Margaret.
Oh, you were Mary Margaret O'Sullivan. Oh, that was very posh. So tell me, what year were you born, Mary?
1931.
And you started your working life in Blarney Woollen.
Yes,
which
that's
was,
where I started,
as you,
and as I said, my mother couldn't afford to send me to a secondary. My father had died when
yes,
I was 11. I was only 11 when my father died.
So you had to go out and find work.
Yeah.
So you got your first job in Blarney Woollen.
Blarney Woollen Mills, yes. I cycled up and down 3 miles each way, 6 miles a day cycling.
And tell me, how did you get the job? Did you have to go for an interview, or how easy or hard was it to get
just
the job?
I just applied.
Just applied?
Yeah, just applied.
Oh, great.
And then
they
called,
yeah. And who were your bosses, did you say, at the time?
Then to Bobby Connell.
Yeah.
He lived in Shamrock Terrace, and Dan Dooley.
And Dan Dooley, indeed.
Dan Dooley and Bobby Connell, you probably heard them.
Dan Dooley. Absolutely, and his daughter, I would have
that's
known.
That's right, yes,
they lived,
yeah.
They lived on the Waterloo Road.
That's right.
So, when you came, you went and worked in the yarn section, and this is a photograph of you here.
Not in that particular machine. I wasn't working, I was working further down the floor.
Okay, but is this you in the photograph?
Pardon? Oh, that's me, yes. Because, as I said, what happened was the photographer came at lunchtime and there were only two of us on the floor.
Oh, that's fine.
And
that's
he said, I'll have to take the photograph, so let you come up here. And the two of us still came up there. You
okay,
know?
And who was this lady here?
Ina Casey was her name.
Ina Casey. Yeah. And so you both worked at that time
in the yarn.
It was
called the combers.
The combers. Because you had to comb out the yarn.
The yarn to get it ready to come up to this. And
yes.
You see, look, it came out there, Freda.
Yes,
you
I
know?
Can see it there.
And then it went on upstairs.
And this was like the natural bonine Aran yarn.
Yeah. And that was in bins, and that went up to the next floor and to the top floor then. That's the way it worked, you
yes.
know? Yeah.
And so after a while, anyhow, you felt you weren't, this section wasn't paying you enough. And tell me then about how you got promoted.
Yeah, I got promoted. I said to him, I don't know, can you get a transfer? Well, I said, if I can, take my notice, please.
So I said that definitely through them.
Oh, we'll give it to you, so he said. So I said, thank you very much. And I was able to earn, I was only earning about £3 or £4 a week in the upper side here. And when I went down to the lower side, I was able to earn £7 and £8 a week.
Oh my goodness, so that was double material. Your wages.
And it was so interesting, Freda.
Yes.
You know, the material,
yes,
to see
I do.
The cloth being made.
The fabric.
Yeah, it was coming out in rolls.
Yes.
But what happened then was, the men gave up wearing suits. They went into casual wear.
Yes.
So the last in, the first out, so I was left go, and that was it.
And were you left go before the mill closed?
Oh, I was, yes.
Yeah, because the mill closed
yes.
was 1973. So when were you let go, do you think?
I said, well, I was left go before, I'm not sure now.
G647, you came to work in the mill.
Yes.
That would have been around the same time that my father was still here, because my father came to work here when he was 13.
Yes.
Well, as everybody in the Blarney area did, they came to work in Blarney Woollen.
Yeah.
So did you, when you were here, did you know my father? Christy Keller?
Christy Keller, I did, yes.
And so you worked in the mill with him?
Sure, there was about 700 or something working.
There was. It was a lot of employment.
Fierce, you know. I mean, the whole families, a whole household were working here, you
they
know.
Were?
Father, mothers, daughters and sons, they were all worked in the mill. It was a great boon to Blarney.
Fantastic.
At the time.
It was the only employer
it was
in Blarney.
The only thing that was there, like, you know.
Yeah. But you had many happy years here.
I had, yes. I was very satisfied when I went down to the weaving shed, because it was very nice too, and the staff were lovely down there. Well, the staff were nice up here too. There was nothing wrong with them like as such. But
the money, the pay was bad.
And it was Christy Nagel was my boss down there.
All right.
And he was lovely. He was lovely.
Yeah, and of course they were all names that we all grew up with in Blarney, because I went to school with all those children. And And so it's amazing now when I walk through Blarney Woollen Mills today, and you know, parts of the old mill that were the combers and the weaving and the sheds and all of that. It are now restaurants and bars, and it's all part of our complex here. And I see you in every day with your husband, Mick, and you're in for your coffee.